Live, this is Doug Nordquist, who will be attempting 7 feet, 7 inches. He has missed on his first two attempts at that height. Jew has cleared 7'7". Stones has cleared 7'7". And now Nordquist. Doug Nordquist making the Olympic team, surprisingly to some, the trials in June. Now visualizing his effort to clear the bar and try to remain alive in this competition.
This will equal Doug Nordquist's personal best, I believe, which is what he had to jump in the trials when he made the team. So this is quite a mental challenge for him. He's been walking through his run-up before he's taken his final set. Here he goes.
Nordquist approaching the bar. No, he does not clear it, and so he will finish in fifth place. Man who is obviously just very, very happy to be on the team. His distant cousin, Stones, still very much alive in his quest to win the gold. And so Nordquist winds up clearing 7 feet, 6 inches, and only those four now remain in the men's high jump as Nordquist and Stones get together, and we'll be back right after this.
They gave up fishing trips, worked longer hours, all so their fellow worker could go see his daughter follow her dream.
Hey, Bob, Carl's daughter's on TV.
Oh, the Olympics.
But they all were there, and they learned that the true measure of the Olympics is not in the winning, but discovering the best in all of us.
What was a light?
There'll be 50,000 people here tomorrow. The Office Automation Expo.
This company is big in computers.
They're just announcing their first system. But one company has it all, right now. Professional workstations, electronic printers, file servers, and they can all work together.
They've already installed more than 800 networks worldwide. What puts this company ahead of the others? Teamwork.
We do. We're back again at the games of the 23rd Olympiad, Los Angeles, California. Let's take a look forward because there's a lot going on tonight, a lot more coming up in boxing. When the evening began, there were five gold medal bouts with Americans in all five. We've already won a couple of them. There's Dwight Stones of the United States. That's a live shot as he gets ready to continue competing in the high jump against Zhou Zhanhua of China, the world record holder. Stones, at the age of 30, won a bronze medal in 1972 at Munich. First said he got interested in the high jump as a little kid when he watched one of our U.S.-Russian track meets from Moscow in 1963. He said he went out in the backyard, put up a couple of sticks, and put another one across and started to jump. He's been jumping ever since. One of the remarkable athletes, and one of the most colorful ones. You know, many, many athletes have told us about this visualization process, but nobody does it quite as specifically and obviously as Dwight Stones does it. When he's standing there doing that little routine, he's actually picturing it, and then the last two steps, boom, boom, the way he does, and going up and over. Well, so far he's gotten up to 7 feet, 7 inches, and the battle between him and the Chinese jumper may very well narrow down to that. So the competition going on, they're wrestling.